we're back. Worth noting that the lead between Innix and Vortex is down to under 5 seconds now on the track. Vortex recovering from that timeout earlier on. They're trying to claw their way back into the lead of this race.
And of course they have the advantage that, well, they don't have the engine damage anymore.
Indeed, that certainly works into their favour. They've just got to be careful not to repeat whatever caused the damage in the first place.
Yeah, it is not really likely that a second timeout would be so lucky. And it can happen now or never. Well, Vortex is not really a challenger for the championship. They have competed in the 24-hour race, but with a different car, so the points they score today are the only points they get from what I think.
Yeah, that's correct. They're in the XR round. The 24 hours in Kyoto, but today, because they've switched to the FXR and series rules, so if you switch car in the middle of a season, then you forfeit all the points that you've gained up until that point.
Yeah, and remembering the 24 hour race, but that was a horrible race for them. At least the beginning of the race was horrible. They were pretty much last right after the first lap because they were involved in an accident. Then they had different difficulties throughout the night. In the end, Vortex managed a 9th place in the 24-hour race. but today it can be better.
The lead is now right down, visibly far closer than it was before. But it's down to half a second at most. Mr. Vansu chasing down Friscops. Friscops and hold on to the lead in the next car, whereas Javancio is in the Montez car, trying to get back into the lead for the first time since their timeout earlier on. That Vortex took 1.6 seconds out of the lead on that last lap alone.
They are flying with this car. New personal best by Christian Kistner.
Now Will Travancu close enough to have a go into the turn 10 hairpin this time around? Nope, it's gonna hang back. Oh, we've got a car upside down, that's Martinez.
Safety car boards and flags, safety car boards
just at
and
the end
flag.
Of the second sector.
So there we go with the next safety car. And this is ending the eventful race for
I do wonder if
the 72.
Indeed, there have been a lot of incidents so far. I was wondering if Vortex would take the opportunity to pit. I'm not sure when they last pitted, but it's been quite a while. But they're staying out for now. Genuine Racing is another car that could pit. There's been about 45 minutes, whether they take the opportunity on the safety car
crashed.
Or not.
Safety car's crashed. Just picked up leader, and Shoemaker has. Well. It's 72 this upside down. I'm not really surprised by that.
No, they've not had a quiet day, let's put it that way.
By the way, any reports on the damage of the safety car?
Just a bit of, quite a lot of pride and a little bit of left front damage. And our safety car driver has used a very disgusting expletive to inform the commentary team of his displeasure at our noticing that he completely failed. car upside down in the pit lane.
There we have the Krumpus in the Green Angus racing car.
Pit exit closed. Car upside down in pit lane. Pit exit will remain closed until car is clear.
This is bizarre.
Bizarre is no word for that.
It's just after pit lane X and someone just left the pits. It's the 54 car. If the pits when exit's closed.
The thing is, what do you want to do as a driver? I mean, you want to stay in competition, and pit lane X. Oh, he waited a few meters behind, it seems. Not a fun day for Ronnie, it seems.
No, it's not the most dignifying way to win your race, being upside down in pit lane exit. But that's the way it is, I'm afraid.
They were running relatively well, I think, as well. Let me see what happened here. So, Hall is giving the car over to Krumpus. Crikey, well. Wow, okay, well. He didn't do it on his own, you might be surprised to know. He had a fairly dumb helping hand from the Infinity Sports amateur car, which saw him pulling out the pits in front of them, and just carried on driving into them, and then flipped them! Drove straight into them and flipped them over so they could carry on their merry way.
What?
Caused the incident themselves by not backing off and leaving room for the car coming out of the pits. So, yeah.
Oh. That's a new one to me. Someone completes his drive-through penalty during a caution.
I imagine they'll be getting a new one after the restart because you can't do that. You can't serve a penalty on the safety car. It defeats the object.
A few days back, I've watched a replay of an old DTM race at the Arvis. The Arvis was also a track where cautions were part of the race. And back then, the rule was you may serve your penalty any time during the race, even under caution. So if someone was caught jump-starting, they simply did the penalty under caution. They were still dead last, but at least they were directly at the end of the pack.
It looks like we'll probably get back to green flag racing at the end of this lap. I don't see any reason at the moment why we won't. And indeed there's confirmation from race control. Unlike the previous two restarts that we've had, this time there's no cars in between the leader and second place, both right together. So it's going to be interesting to see how that changes the way the restart operates. With 2 hours and 34 minutes remaining in the 6 hour race here at South City in the D1 World Series, we're ready to go back green. Robin Friscott's controls the pace.
That's right, he's hit the wall, Steve. He's had an absolute shocker of a restart. Friscott's into the wall as he tried to get the power on, and you're
all sectors
easily
green.
Take
all
the lead, you think.
Green.
You're down into the first corner. How hard is Friscott battling with the tight on the line? Relatively clean so far. Ivanchuk tries to power around the outside. Friscott's holding the inside line. Who's going to break latest? You'd imagine it'll be the bus. Ixon tries to slither down the inside. Here comes the Ixon car as well. But it's Ivanchuk back in the lead now, right around the outside. And they take the lead back. Friscott's again wide. Turn number two. Opening there for the Ixon car, potentially. I think it is, but Totus himself spins. Had nowhere to go, he's sort of stuck in the middle, going into turn number three.
Geranzo already pulling away from Friscott's. Vortex car is about half an hour, well, 20 minutes more into the stint than the Inex car, so they have to come to pits in about 15 minutes. The Inex car could stretch it to to 5 past or 10 past. The top of the hour.
Oh, carnage down in turn number two area. Looks the Conquest car has collided with somebody. Conquest amateur car off to the side there.
Was side by side for, I believe, between Stig Bredenbroeck and Conquest, both the pro cars. The breeding program ahead into turn one. Conquest take a look up the inside two. Gonna get it stopped in time, yes, but Stig Bredenbroeck. It looked like they had the exit, but then they just ran out of room in the exit of turn two. Conquest are ahead. But remain ahead. helped bring Kistner into play in the core broker up run and back of these two. And the green broker went very wide, almost as if it was just pulling over to them. His car through, Perron got through as well in the 18 FXR. Mihaly, I don't know if that's pronounced right, it's Perron. Side by side in turn one. Neither of them quite giving it up yet. Run up the inside and really force the issue on the exit. Not leaving a great deal of space, but he stays ahead.
Safety cars and pit stops and things like that. It's quite sad really that we've lost a few of the good battles we did have.
Run was spun. He lost quite a bit of room of ground. He was coming too close to the car of Kistner. Kistner fighting with Mikhail to the inside, late dive, Kistner in the wall. But the Hungarian stayed behind. Now coming down to the steakhouse hairpin. Kistner defends the inside line. The breeding program not really interested in the move. lost quite a bit of time. Near fastest lap by Samsei Iwanzu.
And that's 3 tenths quicker than anyone has been so far.
Wow.
Previous best was 129.39 and he's just posted a 29.06. Whole third of a second faster than before. He's really on it now, trying to open up this gap.
Knowing that they have to come to pit lane earlier. And we're still on this call versus the breeding program battle.
Stick breeder program spin. It took a look up the inside of turn 11. Not really a sensible way of taking place, and he lost out. He lost the position, I believe, as well. Yeah, the Conquest amateur car got in between. It might have damaged the car, I believe, but it would have cost him a lot of time. Several seconds, which just needlessly thrown away because it's not turn 11 isn't overtaking spot. Try and get the run out of turn 11 and 12 that complex. In the numbers head general racing pro car, he's going to hand over the car to Ivanov.
Yeah, so the XRR is about capable to do 1 hour 10 minute stints, right? This means they have to do a splash and fuel.
Indeed, unless there's another safety car which comes to their rescue and helps them save some fuel. But yeah, it's unlikely that they're going to make it to the end of the race on just one more stop after this.
Except for the little possibility they've got a miracle formula how to do it in this race. 1 hour, 10 minutes ago.
It could be very tight indeed. Whether they'll make it with one more pit stop. If there's no more safety cars, then it'll be very interesting to see how that one plays out. Amateur leaders, Savage Simsports, bring their car into the bits. From 6th overall, very good run. They of course benefited from the early safety car period when they got basically a lap's advantage on the rest of the field purely because of where they were in relation to the overall leader. But they've been doing their stunt job to keep hold of that advantage. And they're going to rejoin, still in the amateur lead, and they're 7th overall.
And now joining us in the commentary booth, the one who just parked his car to give it to someone else. He was the driver of this black and gold livered number 10 genuine racing car just a few minutes ago, Dominic Engel.
Hello. Or have a good night.
So first question.
Yes.
Cornies.
Well, the story about it's quite complicated. Well, it's not really, but
don't have that much action on track. You can basically tell us everything.
Basically, I asked Gerdener, this is, must have been already 12 months ago now, for something that's one-off, something that's based loosely on the Trilly Flying Lizard design, you know, the one in 07 and the 2011, and I never requested anything like it. And after a few months he came out with this, and it had ponies on it, which I didn't expect, so at least those were removed, but I liked the design so much I wanted it to be like that, so that's why it still looks pretty much like a pony skin.
And why can't you use the pony skin? We want the pony skin.
There's not a finished version of this skin with a pony on it, actually.
That's quite sad.
We had a Nine Cat skin back in the day.
The Nine Cat skin's owned. Absolutely owned. I still have them.
Me? I still have them. I still have PSDs for them.
I've still got the pink skins.
Which pink skins? You mean Oh, you mean the one with Cat?
Yes, the Mustang. One with Cat. So how was your stint out there today? Bit of a long pit stop when Robin was handing over to you.
Yeah, we decided to repair damage because we collected a lot of damage through no fault of our own in the first 2 hours, so just to be sure, we bent all the parts back into place so we would have a better car for the rest of the race. Although it didn't help me much because I couldn't get into a rhythm at all in my stint.
Talking about the pony car, I think it's catching NX.
But hey!
Using its pony power.
I don't like the term pony car because it reminds me of Ford Mustangs. Oh, but Robin Friscoff made a big error there. And Pitkin is right through.
Not the first error of Innix today. I mean, driving wise.
Yeah, Friscoff made that with complete hash of that restart!
Oh. He's really lighting up the rear wheels there.
Yeah, that was a bit, close.
I gotta say, I'm not happy with my performance, although it looks better than I think it was, because I could not really get the balance of the car over the whole stint. I think I was like half a second off the pace I was doing half a week ago on the setup, actually. Which is quite weird, and we don't seem to be the only ones who have some issues today.
Are you actually testing the new tyre physics on your car or what?
Yeah, clearly we're testing the new Pirellis. Or F1.
Black Ground Pirelli.
Well, actually, by the way, have you two guys actually watched that interview on of the FIA GT1 World Championship with Pirelli?
Oh, that is fun. I have seen it because I showed it to you.
Yeah. actually,
it was amazing.
The essence of it was tires are black and round.
There's no erase in Italy. That is the only information that video contained.
But the video is just like 6 minutes long.
Well, I think it's certainly got a reasonable length. It's not just like these cuts to pit reporters you get in pre-race shows of American series or something. I mean, it's a proper interview. Although John Watson could have just asked, "What are you here for?" And the guy from Pirelli could have said, "We're Pirelli and provide tyre thingies," and well, that's about it. Which I think was fantastic. Or would have been fantastic, rather.
Well, in a way, it was fantastic to see how many words you can use to describe something very simple.
I wonder whether they still use the same structure this year, or whether they develop anything. Because I presume they won't develop anything at all to keep the price down.
Most likely.
Yeah, tyres, I have to say tyres here, they're not my favourite part of the car on this track. Which is a shame, because that's the only thing that comes to connect to the bloody road.
How did you experience the safety car?
Oh, well, I was overjoyed to have yet another safety car in the middle of my stint. I could barely contain my, yes, my
excitement.
My yes,
that was really over the moon. I think it's the fifth race, and it's the third time I have a safety car in my stint. I was really hoping not to, because we have probably not got the best setup. I mean, it's quite good in the first third of a stint, but then it's a bit understeery, a bit oversteery, a bit shifty in balance. Very hard to get into. I don't know. I managed it fine, I think, in my God knows how many stints I did before the race, but it just didn't work out. Yeah. Although I said it seems to be doing something better. So that's at least one good thing.
First in server, second overall.
I just imagine we would have had that skin in the last race, we wouldn't buy too much.
You mean it's all because of the skin?
Yeah. Well, it's got who knows how many months of work from Gerdener, so
And car 54 will be given a 2-lap penalty for exiting a closed pit exit.
That is the FPP AM car, isn't it?
Yeah. They were in the unfortunate situation that Ronnie Kronkus was flipped right when they were entering for a pit stop.
Indeed.
I heard about that. How did that happen? Because it's not that easy to...
The thing is, he was flipped. That's the important part.
Oh, he was flipped by someone else.
He was flipped by Infinity Esports amateur car. That's Friskops again making a hash of things, I think. Oh, in fact, no, it's not. It's actually Infinity Esports. I was on Warburg. But no, Infinity Esports amateur car. Saw Krompus coming out of the pits in front of him and made no attempt to let Krompus. Krompus had his whole car from the tiniest amount of his rear bumper. He let the Infinity Esports amateur car let the speed limiter roll faster than Krompus, spun him around and then just basically punted him over and continued on his merry way.
Oh well, what a great finisher is. Green Angus Racing.
And Koskinen takes over from Jurvatsu in the leading bus.
Can't be a London bus, or it would be at least 20 minutes behind schedule.
Can't be a German bus, because then it'd be early.
Nah, well, actually, where I live, the buses are in winter. Oh, that's a chat message from 74. Which will probably, it's a nice blue one, but that will probably still result in a drive-through penalty.
Well, where I live, there is a snowflake lying on the street.
Yeah, the
bus
whole,
already
the
10
whole
minutes
public
delayed.
Transport system collapses.
You know nothing until you've experienced British transport in
the
snow.
The best thing is, last year in winter, I had a day off school because the bus driver forgot he had to come to the station where I live.
German efficiency, at its finest. No, I thought you were going to say, Steve, I thought you were going to say that you know nothing until you've experienced the British public transport system.
When it snows, yeah.
Well, what tops everything is, I think, the new German capital airport.
Oh yeah, because you mean it's so busy.
It's so busy that it's
not even finished.
Right. And the parts which are finished are finished so so badly. It would be better to destroy them again and build them up from
scratch. So basically, the NAG has built an airport in the capital city.
Yeah.
That is fantastic.
I mean, Germany is currently full of these working places.
They're building, they're changing the,
Stuttgart main station.
Changing the crossroads down the road where I live. Also, the roads are actually crossing one another. I thought, how useless is that?
You mean like an overpass?
No, I mean it's like you've got one road that's going like vertical. Let's say you draw on a piece of paper, one road goes vertical, and then you have one road
timing out.
Coming from each way on the other side. And yeah, someone is timing out. Should be. Oh, that is Conquest Amateur who just timed out there.
But 54 is cleared to leave, but it's still just sitting in the pit box.
Yeah, the only reason they're changing the road, the way the road goes, is because the two ends of the crossroad on one on either side don't join up.
Oh.
Which is a fantastic waste of money.
Right.
Well, in Scotland, you know, we've got we've been having issues with a bypass, shall we say, and bypassing Aberdeen City, and we finally look like we've got it covered, and now idiot councillors are trying to change the bloody route again, and some stupid wifey suggested building a bloody tunnel, a 28-mile tunnel underground under Aberdeen City. Are you mad?
Wait,
I am mad.
You see, the fashion they have where I live is much cheaper. They're building lots of roundabouts.
Well, we've got those as well. But no, her reasoning
is because they can.
No. Her reasoning why, instead of a road, a ring road around Aberdeen City, is because they wouldn't have to clear the snow.
Can't you just wait till the summer?
You could just spend £10 billion as opposed to £374 million just because you have to clear some snow in the winter. Financial sense, bloody moron. No wonder the city's bankrupt.
I don't know. Do you know what a ton of salt costs?
Not as much as a bloody tunnel.
That's for sure.
What, to melt away the snow?
Yep.
Why don't you just get lots of drunk people pissing on it and melt away as well?
You mean
and
like...
And in Scotland, so you can find many of them.
It's also, it's, doesn't Scotland border, or isn't Scotland closest to Ireland? And even ship drunk people over from there as well.
Just wanted to suggest that. A friend of mine told me that even the English transportation system British transportation system looks good when it snows compared to the Irish.
But the Irish have people like Owen living in it, so it's always going to be the case.
Martin Capel suggests some people melt the snow by crying onto it. That would be a sad time.
I've linked you guys to the aforementioned discussion. Marie Bolton said a tunnel would save the need for snow. Well,
what?
Quite honestly, Marie Bolton, I think that we could use you as a snowplow because that's all you're useful for.
What?
No
if...
clearing would save the need for a tunnel.
Contact between Ixon and Savage Simsports.
It's been a lot of contact today, as expected.
Yes, none quite as worse as Nicky Dakovic doing a J-turn.
Oh,
oncoming traffic.
Yeah, I saw that. I thought there's no... The thing is, he did exactly the same thing in exactly the same place last year. And I thought he would probably learn from it. I really didn't expect him to do it again. Oh well, it's happened now, and it's hard to make something, well, undone. In a time where time travel has not been invented yet.
The thing about the earlier incident with Dakovic is that I think in a moment of panic, actually, I haven't looked at it, he actually just turned the wheel the wrong way because he was going backwards, of course. I think he actually meant the way he'd reversed to go to the right.
I don't think he meant to hit anyone anyways, but I really didn't see how he got hit into the spin, whether that was him.
He got hit into the spin
Yeah,
by...
I think he got hit by the 0-5, he got hit into the spin by the
0-5. He got loose at the apex and tried to sort of slow the car down so he'd actually be able to get a decent exit, and the 05 didn't respond. Basically, he couldn't respond because he was right behind him because Dakovic had just overtaken him. So that spun him around, I think, in a moment, because he was pretty quick to realise that there was going to be an incident there, and he'd probably block up the whole track. And he tried, I think he possibly just went the wrong way by accident because he was disoriented by being backwards, but it still wasn't the brave thing to do.
No, not really. Although, I've got to say, personally, I think the the races are still quite crowded, you know, for this being the fifth race of the season.
And the race after a 24-hour race.
Yeah, the end race after the great race with the best finish ever for third place.
Hey Dom, generally you might want to tell Mr. Pinkerton to easy off the clutch.
I think he knows about that.
No, he does!
I think he almost made a bigger mistake than flat shifting and with a red clutch.
By the way, Dom, what did you think about the incident of Robin Heilman and
Virus in turn
Virus,
one?
Yeah.
Well, personally, I only saw it on stream. And on stream, yeah, you have the shot come from, you know, under the bridge, looking straight ahead to the start finish straight, and I saw both cars side by side, and suddenly the Virus car at a 45 degree angle, and I kind of knew by that point it would have to be lag. So, as far as I know, the protest, well, it has been dropped, but it's been decided it was a lag incident, so... I didn't see the other one he protested, but I saw that one and I thought, well, hopefully... I mean, it wasn't good for either them or us, because, well...
Oh, there's a car off! It's a 54 car off, stick breeding program, and he's gone off on a straight.
Also, it's worth to note that
it's got timed out.
Oh God, that's a disaster for.
And Isaac's directly in the server, and Lavis directly.
The whole server's lagging. I think the whole server's lagging. The lag bars are going absolutely crazy.
Question is, the team speak on the same server as the for speed? Okay, this explains why you sound so laggy to me.
More people are gonna fly.
The whole plate is going down, boys. Come back on just in front of Vortex.
Who knows what this is all about again?
Oh, I've been up now! Tom, you're required to drive. Just to get back at the server. Change your name and go. Oh, this is terrible, right?
Yeah,
I think this will be a red flag situation. So many cars
stoppage.
Are timing out at the moment, and so many lag bars are going all over the place.
We've heard Friskop's timeout so far, we've heard Ivanov and Jackson. I don't know if that's said right in the 05 car. There's three of them so far.
Safety car boards and flags, please. Safety car boards and flags, please. Lag situation. Lag situation.
Laris Matonis out as well.
I think that the. We're going to hope and pray that this gets better, I suppose, but. We still have considerable amount of lag bars going crazy on the server.
Safety car go, safety car go.
Indeed, I believe it was the first round at Blackwood which was cut short because of trouble with lag as well. An hour or so short. So, second time in five rounds we've had. Lag issue.
I just get the feeling that we should probably red flag this one, but Deco will take his decision, I suppose. 71 for some... Oh, 71's got massive issues turning the corner there. I think. We just let every 300 safety car, which is a bit strange. Yeah, this is pretty crazy now. We have been informed we will be going to a red flag situation in an attempt to save the server from kablowing itself up. Racing 2 are the leaders. It's a little bit confused right now, though, of course. We do apologise for this issue, and we do apologise if there is lag coming through the TeamSpeak. Continuous lag issues here.
Got a couple more timeouts of 56 and 54 cars have timed out. And that's 56, the leader in the AM category.
It's not going to make that much of a difference. I think we will probably go back a couple of laps.
I imagine so.
Or started blowing up.
There's about 6 or 7 drivers that we've had timeouts so far, I believe. And there's the red flag being brought out by race control.
No choice. You got to have everybody dying a death. There goes Dakovic now. I don't know, I'm not going to say that. I was going to say our connections are fairly good here, Steve. We haven't timed out. What's going on here?
So the field is being brought to the start finish straight and brought to a halt. Race being stopped while this whole lag issue is hopefully resolved.
Yeah, so the problem definitely is the physical server, so really the data center, because I get reports from the Genuine Racing server that they are lagging. TeamSpeak there is also lagging. So it's going to be interesting to see what's going to happen here. I wonder if I'm even understandable on the stream. Oh well, that works. Nicky Dakovic timed out.
while we're under this red flag, it's worth mentioning it's been a ruling by the stewards with regards to Ronnie Krompus's retirement. The number 59 car, which is the Infinity Esports amateur car, had received a stop go from the stewards for that incident in the pit lane, which resulted in Krompus ended up on his roof pit lane exit.
I'm back. What do I have missed during my absence?
Lots of packet loss.
Lots of packet loss, yeah.
The best thing is, trying to join when you can't even join is fantastic.
Yep.
I think my J button is broken now, because the hammer is so hard.
There's a nice little story. I was talking about Terror Mind Factory earlier. They actually pulled out of City League because they said the servers are too unstable.
Yeah, because they had one connection issue in 10 years.
I think it was, to be realistic, it was one connection issue in 3 years.
Well, 2 then. 2 or 3 years, but it's still a shame, you know. It's the second time this season that we have a problem.
I'm having some fun in the rescue car right now.
Car game also has issues.
Yeah, well, all those servers, our servers, the NDR servers, the car game servers, they're all in the same data center, so.
Where's the data center?
Paris, I think.
Paris.
I could be wrong though, so don't stone me to death if I'm not right. Currently sitting here with a lovely 37% packet loss. Which is a lot. It's even more than DHL loses every year.
Yeah.
I wonder if I can make out to third gear.
It is also very funny for me to listen to all guys here in the commentary box. Yeah, they are sounding for me like machines.
Not just for you, it's for everyone and for the stream as well.
Yeah, for the stream now as well. Some minutes ago, it sounded nice there.
Really? Oh yeah, yeah. It does. Whoa.
Yeah, that's the surprising fact here.
Wherever the thing is, we need to go there.
I don't think that Lutz will wants to have a call another time at this time of day, I mean. We've had to call him earlier already, so.
Or can you please lend us all your hardware?
To wall, and that's a spin.
So you now doing a forced simulation of the what's the Yas Marina 12 hours?
Yas Marina 12 hours.
Mm-hmm. There's a 12-hour race on the
really small track.
Yas Marina circuit, and it's split up into 2 6-hour races.
This little mini track here is actually quite challenging.
What, the Abu Dhabi track?
No, the one I'm driving just now. I'm trying to entertain everybody and get myself entertained. What the hell?
And then, Chris, you learn why driving counter course isn't always the best option.
So, I actually currently have deja vu.
Why? Has the internet been shut off again?
No, but I just clicked on Chris Ford driving around this mini pit lane.
Oh, well, I can't even get onto the server.
Oh! Good sign!
And on sitting on the server now, all I see is lots of cars appearing and disappearing all the time.
We have somebody here, apparently. Hello, Isaac Price from NX. How have you had fun today?
It's been alright. Better than I expected.
Yeah, what was your reaction? Because your car was actually, of course, the first one to have an issue with the connection. Did you just think it was Robin's
property? No, I was on the remote, and he said, I'm lagging out. And I was like, no, it's the server. But our pit stop was about to happen anyway, but I didn't think he was actually timing out, because I saw him reappear. But I thought, well, our pit stop's going to be soon, so I'll join anyway. And I was like tabbing through the cars looking for him. And then he timed out, so I was like, oh, and then joined. So, it worked out okay for us. We actually technically would have gained time from it because we came out, Robin timed out literally just after the line and he had to do a pit stop, so.
I'd love to know what Nicky Dakovic is doing. This isn't going to help, Nicky. You're going to be sitting here for a little while doing tire warming isn't going to help. And it appears you've hit the wall as well, so.
In which way does he do time on? Does he sit there doing burnouts?
I have to do it all over again.
The great talent, Nicky Dakovic. But I guess at the moment it looks like the race will get called off, seeing as it seems like it's a more widespread issue than just this server.
Yeah, but it's not just this specific server.
Yeah, so they're not going to be able to do anything, I would have thought, but.
Fantastic thing is when you just sit there wanting to join, you hammer the J button for 2 minutes, and then you join, and you find out you forgot to change your name, you want to spectate again, and then you can't spectate anymore. That is what you call connection quality.
First world problems.
Yes.
It's bad though, they're actually lagging less now than I would normally.
The best thing is I so far haven't managed to stay on the server for more than 5 minutes.
How does it feel, Isaac, to be Portuguese?
makes me feel kind of humid.
And probably makes you feel warm.
Yeah.
Because it's not shit.
It makes driving LFS much harder because you sweat a lot more.
But I have to say, I have the exact opposite problem. If it's warm outside, it makes it a lot more easier because I don't have to turn the heater up.
Have you got a sunburn yet this year?
No. you know, I'm ginger, you can't let that happen. It would be against my nature. I've got to stay pale white. You can't let that change.
I'm just imagining you, your face bright red and your hair and...
What'd you do to stay pale white?
Huh?
Factor 70.
Well, it's a shame Michael Jackson's dead. I'm pretty sure he could have recommended you something. So there are, I think, 3 options being considered now what to do with the situation as it is. According to Deco, at least, and probably to the rule book, / sporting code, / all those paragraphs that not too many people know of or remember. Nicky Dakovic continues today's record of timing out.
We should call Guinness, maybe it's a new world record.
I'd rather just have a Guinness, not a Guinness world record.
Okay, with my sponsorship involvements, I shouldn't have said Guinness.
What skins?
I said Guinness.
Oh, well, that shows you what TeamSpeak lag does. Best thing is it still fine to people on the stream?
If you turn on the stream, it's a crystal clear voice for everyone.
Well, that's fantastic, because that will make me sound like an old man. What did you say? I can't understand you. Speak louder.
My hearing don't work. Don't know why I went Russian.
But yeah, the lag bars are still going up and down like the petrol prices around the world.
Petrol prices don't go down, so...
Well, they do go down by half a cent. To then go up by 10.
You know why? Because at the end of the month, there's Easter.
Well, that's me gone again.
Why is there on BBC News an article called Girl Woke Up Naked with Two Men? I thought that was more like what was it called? That yellow press thingy.
That's on BBC News.
That's on BBC News.
Well, they just let themselves go.
What is it you're looking at? Dog TV launch for Home Alone pets.
Well, presumably not Home Alone pets, just Home Alone dogs. Dog TV wouldn't work very well if you got a hamster, would it?
Also, it is said that if you divide the pings of the top 10 drivers by 10, you will have the results of your country's lottery
for the next jackpot. However, I'm not sure whether that is true.
No guarantees on this call.
Oh, that's my sixth time out. Well, not sixth time, it's actually my fourth time out.
I really have to wonder what internet line here the streaming computer has.
A magic one.
I think the internet line is as big as the house I'm living in. So like 100 meter in diameter.
Well, I just had my internet upgraded, so it's ridiculous. But my connection doesn't work now, so it makes me feel like I've been teleported back into the 90s and someone keeps picking up the phone.
Yeah. I remember this one Simpsons episode where at the beginning there was a joke about it.
I loved the bit more where Homer set up a company in the internet without actually having any internet, and he just put some sign saying internet next to him, so...
Okay.
Or something like that. It's been quite a while since I've seen that. I'm getting old. My memory isn't getting better. I'm timing out again.
I recommend write it down. Then you can't forget it. You can only burn it. Oh, a status update by Genuine Racing of 18 minutes ago. Red flag, server issues, current standings.
Current standings could be wrong.
I'm going to go back to my rallycross driving.
You're doing rallycross driving?
Yes.
Where?
The server.
Oh. That's not rallycross, unless you're American and you're told that global rallycross is done round the pit lane of a oval.
Well, from what I've heard, Global Rallycross shall go to Europe this year. And from what I've heard, one of the tracks might be the Olympic Stadium of Munich.
Oh, well, was R2-R3 not good enough for them? Not R2-R3, I mean, sorry, that's what happens when I read and think. I mean, was DTM not good for that stadium? Oh my hell, oh god, I don't think I've ever failed that badly. But then, reading and talking at the same time, bad idea, unless you're reading something out loud. Which, in which case, talking is quite important. Dear, who would
Chris
have thought
Ford
that could ever happen?
Moment live on the stream.
Does the rescue car need a rescue car?
Yes, the rescue car does need a rescue car.
Rescue car to the rescue. Car.
Here's job done. No. Just help me.
I've now reached a stage where I instantly start timing out after joining.
So I read that Car Game actually said that there is a problem with the hoster. So what we thought earlier seems to be true.
Yeah, it seems to affect all server in that area, all servers in that area, which is a bit of a shame, but. Unless someone can wave a magic wand and make it all work again, we might be in a bit of trouble.
I guess no one's really close enough to London to catch the train to Hogwarts, is one? I mean, when you speak of magic wands.
Ironic thing is, this is the second race within not quite half a year where this happened.
So, checkered flag is out, the race is declared.
Oh well, that's well.
Two wins! I'm trying to work that
what?
Out.
What?
Two
do you
wins.
Mean? I don't actually know what the positions are.
Did I fall into German? What?
I think Genuine Racing 2 have won this race.
I think there's the need for a rollback, so...
Yeah.
Yes, but I think that they were ahead, because... Yeah, I'm pretty sure they've won this race. The pony car, I think, has won.
What's with Vortex? So, okay.
I think we'll find out in the next few minutes who's where, why, and how.
It's also important to note that we're only 5 minutes past 75% distance. Rolling back would presumably...
Yeah, but if the race is declared, then it's only going to be half points. Because frankly, we 75% would have to be not 4 hours and 10. Would have to be 4 hours 30, so...
So yeah, let's wrap it up. So, yeah, what is there anything you guys want to talk about? I think I take this as a no. Yeah,
well,
what to plug?
Oh yeah, I know what to plug.
Oh yeah. The second ever German voiced Dominic.
What?
On Monday.
Oh yeah, that's on Monday.
Monday City League.
I almost said Mondays on Monday. Wow. But yeah.
Go ahead.
Yeah, City League 17 round 3 with Dominic Engel, but in German.
No. Now everyone knows.
Now everyone knows you can speak German.
There was that rumor once, but I couldn't at all. Which I thought was fantastic. And what else is happening next weekend? GT1 racing on a server that doesn't have to last even 4 hours. Is going on with the Genuine Racing GT1 Challenge on SO Town because I didn't get permission to use the highway. I think it's the fifth round of the season out of 7. Mathematically, anyone joining is still eligible for the championship. Everyone else retires, doesn't join a race, and the person gets all 3 poles, wins all 3 races, has fastest lap, and most laps led.
True. What do we else have in the next days?
S3! Yeah, S3 is going to be released on the 30th of February this year.
Don't forget, it's also on the Starter Center. It's hosted on the Data Center that we are currently hosted on.
Oh yeah,
there's going to be this this little oval race, the 2013 Kyoto 250 at the end of this month. To be exact, on Easter's Saturday.
What's on that weekend?
Kyoto 250.
I know something that's much more important that's on that weekend, but...
That's on Easter Sunday, the... Then yeah. GT1 Challenge Round 6.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't even know it was on Easter Sunday. I just picked some Sunday.
Yeah, it's Easter Sunday.
You know what's on the same weekend, though, which is what I meant. It's the completely new FIA GT series.
Yes, right.
Which is going to be broadcast live here in Germany on television, and I wonder how bad it's going to be.
But it's on RTL, so...
Well, let's say the opportunity for something really good's there. However, I don't think it's going to be taken up.
For all non-Germans, RTL is... the most successful German private television channel, but also the one with the lowest intelligent level.
Well, not that, but with the most scripted reality stuff.
So, with the lowest intelligent level.
Just like Big Brother, but they're only pretending.
Yeah, right.
Although, actually, no, they also broadcast Big Brother, don't they?
They do. This little Endermore show. We're still standing by for the rollback.